Rob G, and welcome to Wicklow's historic jail. Tonight, myself and a team from East Coast FM are on the search for paranormal activity. Wicklow Jail is said to be one of the most haunted places in Ireland, so welcome to the gates of hell.
We're here to talk to Marie. She's the curator and she works here at Wicklow Jail. She's going to give us a bit of history on the jail and also give us some details on some of the paranormal activity that's happened here. Hi, Marie.
Hi, how are you? You're very welcome, lads. I work in the jail and I also act in the jail. I play the matron, Mary Morris, and we do a tour every 10 or 15 minutes and we start here at these gates. And these are the original gates. They're here since 1702 and they're called the Gates of Hell. They're called that by the prisoners themselves because each man knew once he went through them, there wasn't much hope of coming back alive.
Yeah, folks, what we have here is an example of the cells from the 1700s. There were six cells when the jail first opened. They were roughly the same size as this cell, and there would be 100 prisoners in a cell this size, men, women and children, thrown in together.
It feels very cold. It's early in the night. People are getting a smell already down here. As it's very early, people still haven't really gotten into the feel of it yet. The place is still noisy from us walking around. I'd be really interested to see how people get on when it's quieter and people are maybe in smaller groups. What about you, Michelle?
I've been looking at the temperature readings and it's actually higher down here than it is upstairs, which is, it shouldn't be that.
I definitely feel something different in here. It's not really that bad, but I have that heavy feeling again on the back of my neck and I can get that smell again.
And at what point did you get that heavy feeling?
Just when I walked in the door. Would it be right in saying that it could be a feeling of somebody waiting to get out of here? Kind of like a pacing up and down.
Yeah,
and it's like...
That's exactly right.
That's right.
Angie and I are convinced that the first time I ever walked into the jail, I walked down at the bottom there, down towards the dungeon, the stairs of the dungeon, and I felt very sick underneath those stairs. And then as you come up the stairs, you get quite dizzy. We're convinced that more than one person died in that spot directly below the stairs.
Okay, this is Wicklow Jail. We're in cell 21 at the moment, and we've just had a bit of problems with this very mic in my hand in that we were getting distortion. And the battery power, as you can see, maybe you can't, but... it's on 2 at the moment and we shouldn't be getting any distortion on the microphone, but we are for some reason in this cell. But we'll try and get more on that maybe later on.
What was that?
What did you hear?
I heard some kind of a boo-boo-boo like a noise. Yeah.
Is that sort of thing?
Yeah, I got that in the earphone.
Anyone else pick up that?
Let's see if we can get any response. Give me 2 bangs back, please.
Just
try it again.
As still as possible, folks.
Okay, I'm going to do it again. If that was you, thank you very much. But can you do it louder for me, just to confirm that it really is you? Okay. There you go. Thank you. Thank you so much. We'll be back later to communicate with you.
You picked up that audio, Ryan? You did.
Yeah, we did.
Okay. Okay, it's East Coast FM. We're here in the Wicklow Jail, one of the most haunted places in Ireland, and we're here on what's called the ship, which used to be the chapel. Now, Angie is here with us and has knocked, looking to speak to a spirit, knocked twice, and we got a response. We got a slight knock, a faint knock, but a knock nonetheless. So we're going to come back here later on and see if there's any more we can get from the spirit that is most definitely around here at the moment and around us all. So what's the plan? What are we doing?
What you need to do is very gently, just put your finger very gently, very, very lightly, even just resting above it with a good enough bit, just very gently on there.
Okay.
A couple more. Well, just think of the name Andrew. Come on, Andrew, I know that that's you. Start moving the wood around the table. Show them what you can do. Show
them. Oh, moved. Definitely
brilliant.
Moved.
Brilliant. Thank you. Bring it over to me. Right, that's it. Come on, Andrew, bring it. Start moving it around for me. Confirm that you were a prisoner in this jail. Can you confirm that for me, please?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Oh, that definitely moved.
Thank you. Can you confirm it stronger for me? Take it across just a little bit stronger for me. Just move it stronger.
It's moving. It's moving.
Thank you. So you were a prisoner in this jail. Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much. Okay. Did you die here, Andrew? If you did, can you confirm that by moving the wood, please? I want him to move this stronger. That's nothing to what it can do. Come on, sweetheart. Do you know what? Where's Patrick?
Yeah.
Patrick, I'm being drawn downstairs. I've been told to go down.
Yeah, try and cast.
We've just done a little exercise over there with a table to see if we could get it to move, or see if we could get the planchette to move. There was a little bit of movement, but not an awful lot. So we're going to go downstairs now, and hopefully we'll get something else, a little bit more substantial. So let's go downstairs.
Yes,
there's
all lights off.
All lights off, so.
Give him that one, yeah? Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have all the switches off. Okay, Spirit, I want you to draw close, so I want you to come into this circle. I want you to let us know that you are with us. If possible, I'd like you to start raising some of the hands in the group.
Good luck, mate. Come on in. Bring the rest of the kids in with you. We played this game before. I know how much fun you have doing it. What I want you to do is to make these people all look really, really silly.
Move their hands up. Take their hands up. Take it into them. Take them forward into the centre of the circle. Bring their hands up.
Your hands definitely.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you do it stronger? Take it into the centre for me. Move it into the centre and other people's hands as well. Start lifting their arms up.
I don't know if the other guy that was beside me. I felt my arm just moved forward.
Because we'd asked.
And then I just got this overwhelming, dizzy feeling, and I just.
Yeah.
But a lot of the time, Ryan, what happens is they can imprint on us what they experienced down here, and you can end up crying your eyes out or being feeling sick, anything.
Ryan, can you just describe to myself and maybe the listeners what just happened?
We were in there and everyone was in darkness and I was fine and I was actually kind of laughing a little bit because I thought how silly it was, and Patrick came behind me and I could feel my arm moving and I said to the guy beside me, I said, can you feel that? He said, yeah, and then within 10 or 20 seconds my arm just kept moving forward and I just got this feeling that I can't even describe of something behind me. I got dizzy for a second and then I just lost. I just got this feeling. All right, we've just finished our paranormal investigation here at Ian Wicklow Jail. It was an interesting night. One thing in particular happened to me, which I'm sure you've seen on the film, which was down in the school area. Some other bits and bobs. It's certainly an eerie place. We just spent some time in South 13. So definitely, you can definitely get a feeling. Lots of feelings I got anyway from various smells to noises, all that kind of stuff. So it's now 10 to 12. We were supposed to finish up at 10, so we've gone way over time. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you again soon. Thanks.